Today I am going to teach you how to run a webinar using Zoho Showtime. Zoho Showtime is a very nice system to run webinars. I tried multiple systems before I started to work with Zoho Showtime. I think Zoho did a very good job with this product. Now, one more feature that you have in Zoho Showtime that you don't have in other webinar programs is that it's integrated with Zoho. So let's say that I have 100 people registered to my webinar. In a click of a button, I can push them into Zoho CRM as new leads, and then I can process and start contacting them. So that's also very cool. If you watched my YouTube channel, you saw that in the last few weeks I started to run webinars. Now, the idea for me to create the webinars is just another way to create more content to my YouTube channel, and of course on the way to help people with their questions and needs. So it's a win-win for me and also for my audience. What I did not expect is to have a very big boost to my sales. Because of those webinars, I'm selling much more courses, I'm selling more products, I have much more traffic coming into my business, which is something I did not expect or planned. I'm saying it just because you can see what are your expectations when you're running a webinar. Okay, so I think it's very, very good for any business to run webinars and provide value to the marketplace, and it's coming back to you 1,000 times fold. Now, if you have Zoho One, let's install a Showtime. Let's click on the admin panel. Let's go to the applications and let's click on add application. And here we are going to search for Zoho Showtime. And this is the guy. Let's click on add. And today I'm going to show you how to run a simple webinar with some things that I learned from my personal experience. Okay, Showtime is ready. Let's click on Zoho Showtime. And by the way, if you need a Zoho One account or you need a Zoho Showtime license or even a trial account, feel free to check the link below. You have a link for a Zoho One free trial. I will be very happy if you will do it using me, because I will get a small commission from Zoho and I'm giving you also something in return. So you will be happy, I will be happy. Okay, so this is the first screen that you can see when you're logging into Zoho Showtime. On the left side, you have library of different assets that you uploaded in advance. And I will show you soon how I'm using this library. You can have your different settings, but we're not going to do it right now. Let's go into our session and let's create a new session. The remote session that I'm going to broadcast will be, let's say, helping my clients. And that will be for November 15, 2020. You will have some kind of a description for what is the session is all about. If you want to run it, let's say weekly or monthly, whatever. For me, I set it up to weekly, because in my system, every week there will be another session. So in my case, it will be weekly, but you can change it, of course. And I will click on create session. Now that the session is created, you have a few options here. In my case, the session is free, but you, if you want, you can also charge for your sessions, no problem with it. In the session itself, you can see who are the people that are going to be the presenters. You can add co-trainers, which means more presenters to the system. You can also have people that are outside of your organization, that they will be guest trainers. When the session will be over, you will get a recording. It takes about 1 hour or so until you get the recording, and then you can download it and you can edit. In my case, I'm running a green screen. So whenever I'm running the sessions, I'm able to filter the green screen and then I am showing like I am behind the presentation, which I think it's cool, right? Because people can see you and also see your presentation. Not bad. From here, we are going to upload materials. And what I tried last time in my last webinar is actually upload a video while I am running the webinar. The problem is that I'm a one-man show. I don't have people around me that's helping me in the webinar. So I need to present and also answer questions at the same time. That's a problem, right? Cannot duplicate or replicate myself. So what I did, I just uploaded a video. The video was running. Of course, I told the audience, I'm going to run the video of this presentation for 15 minutes. And while it's running, I can answer questions. And that was very, very cool. So while the video was running, I was able to chat and communicate with people that were in listen mode to the webinar. So that's something that I can recommend you. It's very, very cool. You can run some polls, which, you know, whenever you're running the webinar, there will be a pop-up. So let's start uploading from my computer. Let's go to so let's have this one. That was the video that I used. And by the way, when I produced the video for 16 minutes, it was about 1 gig. And when I uploaded it to YouTube, it became like 200 megabytes. And then I downloaded it and uploaded here. So basically I had two steps. YouTube became my engine to reduce the size of the file. Okay, because here I'm limited to something. I don't remember how much, but no, it's not saying. But when I uploaded, it just said that 1 gig is just too much. So I had to reduce the size of the file. Let's create a poll. And the poll will be, let's say, are you happy? And yes, that's fine. 1 will be no, 10 will be yes. Let's create the poll. What else? And handouts. This is very, very important. So let's upload handouts. And the handouts will be something that you can give the audience. For example, for me, it's important that people will know about my Zoho CRM courses, any courses, or my products. I have lots of stuff that I can give. And this is where I do it. So if you look at the handout that people can download at any time, you have here link to the questions and answers once a week. You can order a consultation session. You can take my course. You can create a Zoho One account. So a few things that I want to provide to the public, and that's using the handouts, which I think they're very, very good. Let's go here, let's go back. In the registration section, you will see all the people that attended your session. The people that registered, and after the session, you see all the people that attended and did not attend. And based on that, you can send them different type of marketing materials. You can have certifications in case that you are going to have anything that is more than just a basic webinar. In my case, of course, I'm not going to give certification for attendance. And you can also, of course, promote your webinar on your website and other places, and therefore you can have some kind of an embed or a link. And yep, here you will see all the people that you invited personally and all the people that registered to your sessions. I personally promote the webinar both on my website and the YouTube session, and I think it's very cool. And here you will have different kind of settings. Let's launch this specific webinar. And first of all, you will see here that the system will ask you to provide some kind of approval if you want to use the microphone and also the speakers. So I will write allow here and also allow for the camera. And you should see me here very, very soon. Let's adjust the camera. Yes, allow. And perfect. So you can see me here. You can see the green screen behind me. And we have also the microphone, which is this guy. This is the blue snowball. I have also the Yeti, which I recommend on both of them. Very, very cool. This guy, the blue snowball, cost about $70 or so. The Yeti cost me about $300. So, and both of them doing the same work. So do the math. Let's click on continue. And first of all, the system will ask you if you want to start broadcast, so you can see how you look like, you know, you can play with yourself. And if everything looks great and you're ready to broadcast, you will click on start broadcast. On the bottom, you will have your mic and your camera. So I will click on start broadcast. By default, I want all the recordings to start. So I will click here on start recording. And now the session is also recorded on the computer. If you remember, I told you that I uploaded the video. So what I did, I clicked here on play. So now I am running the session there. And while I am there, I was able to chat with my audience and get their questions and answers and play with it. So that was phenomenal. It was very, very good experience. Of course, not all the 1 hour was recorded. Only the, shut up. Now, just the demo part, which is part of my webinar, the demo of about 15 minutes, it's recorded, and the rest of it, it's live. So I'm able to interact and work with people. When you're on the webinar, you can click on invite and you can click on copy and you can send people over email or chat to join the webinar. You can click on people and see all the people that are attendees in this webinar, and you can click on trainers. When you have people that are attending, you can give them ability to talk. And this is a big thing for me. If they want to talk, they will request from their side. And you just need to click on approve. I love this feature. I don't want to chat with people. I'm already overwhelmed with thousands of things. I want to be able to do my job the best way. And if people are able to talk to me, this is natural. This is how it should be for me. And this is perfect. If you have more trainers, they can also take over the questions and answers, and they can help you run your session. The polls, let's say I click here on start poll, and people can say if they're happy, and if while they're running the poll, you can see the numbers changing, and whenever you're ready, you can click show result to everyone, and everybody can see the results. I really, really like Showtime. I really like what Zoho did here, especially the price, but I will show you the price in a second. I'm not selling you anything, but I will show you the price once I finish that. In the chat, you can chat with specific people, and that's also great. And this is the handout that I told you. When people click on the handouts, they can download it and it will be on their computer. So it's another way to publish your assets to the audience. Whenever you finish with the session, you will click on end on the bottom. On the bottom, you will see that you can mute and unmute your mic. You can show and hide yourself from the camera. Let's say you want to sneeze or something. So you're closing the camera, closing the mic, just, and then you continue. You can share different materials, which in my case, I have only the video, but you can have PowerPoint presentations, whatever is conventional in running webinars. You can share different screens. So let's say that I share my entire screen and then you can see exactly what I see. So the entire screen will be shown. And whiteboard, I don't use whiteboard, I'm not that artistic, but let's say I want to show you how a landing page looks like. That's the best I can do, believe me. And let's do something like that. Hey, very nice. Okay, so Let's close this whiteboard. We'll close my disgrace. So this is really what I wanted to show you about Showtime. I think it's a product well designed, very easy to use. The audio quality in the past 5 webinars was great. I was very surprised. The product, I promised you. So Showtime pricing. So Zo Showtime. Yeah, Zo Showtime. So Zo Showtime will cost you. Where is the comparison? No comparison. So $5 a month will cost you the basic one. I don't know how many people. You know what? Most small businesses will have about 10 people in a webinar, maybe 50. So for $8 a month, it's not bad. The competition will be 100 all the way to 300 or 400 depending on the platform. So I don't think that that's too bad. If you have Zo One, you're getting the Enterprise Edition, which is, you know, the best edition. You're getting it for free. And Zo One will cost you $30 per month, and you're getting it for free together with another 50 business applications. So I think they have a great offering. I'm really, really happy with the way that I'm running those webinars. The technology part is relatively easy for me, because the rest, the delivery and preparing the content, answering questions, this is the overwhelming part. But technology-wise, simple. Thank you very much for watching this session. If you have any questions, comments, anything, shoot them in the comments below. If you like the channel, subscribe. I have tons of Zo-related content. I will see you in the next session.